at nine.
All right, what do you say we start at number nine?
All right.
It's Monday, so you're probably tired. You might want to think about grabbing an ostrich pillow.
Oh.
You can put it on your head and
that.
You can sleep anywhere.
Oh.
Or you can use it as a pillow,
sure.
Obviously.
Sure.
This versatile product, get this. It only costs $98.
Really?
And you can find it on the old Amazons.
Oh, well, the ostrich pillow. Look how comfortable it looks down there.
Zero suffocation risk at all.
No, yeah, we got the hole right there for you.
You still have that you can still hear with
yeah.
the...
Yeah, that's great.
That's fun.
Number eight, some research into what took down the woolly mammoth. A study says that some of the world's last remaining woolly mammoths died of thirst. The ancient animals were still living on a small island off the coast of Alaska until about 5,600 years ago. A report from St. John's College at the University of Cambridge says rising ocean levels at the end of the Ice Age shrank their island home and inundated freshwater reservoirs with seawater. It was a lack of fresh water that finally did them in. I thought they were hunted to death. I didn't know.
Now you know. No. Number seven. Happy Monday. Let's talk about toilets for a second. For the longest time, toilets were not allowed on television.
Yeah.
Not a mention of them, and definitely no scenes involving them. In 1957, Leave It to Beaver showed a toilet, kind of. Wally and Beaver hid a baby alligator in the toilet tank. Back in the late 60s and early 70s, the Brady Kids shared a bathroom, but we never once saw a commode. In fact, there wasn't one, which puzzled and confused viewers. In 1971, a flushing toilet was heard, but never seen in an episode of All in the Family.
It's your kind of TV, right, Larry?
Yeah,
keep
well,
that toilet
maybe,
humor out
maybe
of
they realize people at home really don't need to see it.
Don't need to see a toilet. They know what it looks like.
Not an important part of the plot.
Unless it's an alligator in the toilet.
Yeah.
All right, number six, if you're a Star Wars freak like me, well, you'll probably want a pair of these lightsaber chopsticks.
Oh, yeah.
They light up just like the real thing, and they're chopsticks, so you can use them to eat your sushi or your pizza or whatever you want to do with them.
Yeah.
It's the epitome of cool right there.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Looky. Love.
If you're looking for you and Mrs. Conrad right here.
That'll do it.
Of course, you need to get her to eat a meal with you first.
Right? Yeah.
Exactly. That's the first battle.
Yeah, good luck.
Number five, we mentioned Lake Titicaca last week.
Oh, yeah.
And more than a few viewers asked to explain how it got its name. It's in the Andes Mountains, the largest lake in South America. It straddles Bolivia and Peru. Now, the terms titty and caca can be translated in multiple ways.
All right.
You see, titty can mean anything from puma to metal.
Titty can?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
And
caca.
Caca, yeah, I'm getting there. Caca has meanings like the word crack. But anthropologists figured out that the Native American tribe that lived there in the 1900s used the word to mean gray-colored puma. And this refers to a rock on an island in Titicaca that is considered sacred. It has the shape of a puma, and this is likely where the name comes from.
Uh-huh.
That story made zero sense to me whatsoever.
Yeah.
Because I was lost.
I think
lost.
You were a little distracted.
I was a little
Lake
lost
Titicaca.
About a third of the way through that story. So forgive me if that read was not.
No,
it was okay.
Was it okay?
Did you understand what I said?
Because I didn't.
It was part of the language of the tribe. So if they said, hey, Johnny, when you go out, be careful with the Titicaca, they didn't all go.
Yeah. Right.
Like that was just what they referred to, to puma. It was,
right. It's a geography.
You lost
story.
Me at all those different meanings for titty.
We didn't really go into that.
That's where I was gone, so forgive
we
me, everybody at home.
Yeah.
I apologize.
Lake Titicaca.
Anyway.
Number four, if you don't know just how big eagles are, this very short clip gives you an idea.
Wow. The size of that beak.
Depends on what you're watching. And if you're watching on your phone, this doesn't look that big, but you got a big screen TV.
See, what we always say, you need a human being next to it.
Yep.
Right, but we don't know if that's like a 5-year-old
Absolutely
kid
right
or
there.
Yeah, it could be a toddler.
True.
I was hoping to see the wingspan. Really
yeah, she should let it go. Like, context, look at the towel, yeah. Though,
and... Wow.
Look at that face.
Happy. Look at
majestic.
It's... It's like it's perpetually telling you it's going to kick your ass.
Yeah. That is an angry bird right there.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah. I'm...
To kill you to smile just a little bit. Right. I mean, you're
I
the bird of America.
I don't think they're capable. I think they have RPF yeah. a little bit.
The old, yeah.
Yeah. Huh.
Shame.
Number three, you may need less sleep than other people depending on your genetic makeup. Neuroscientists at the University of California, San Francisco have found that two genes that determine how much sleep we need. If you have one of the two short sleep genes, you probably feel well rested after only 4 to 6 hours of sleep. That's compared to the 8 hours most people need. Anybody here think they have that gene? Oh, I have it.
You have it?
You feel good after
I only ever get
hours.
4 to 6 hours.
And you
yeah,
feel
but isn't
good,
that sleep
though?
Deprivation?
Yeah,
just
I feel good when I wake
it.
Up, and, you know, in 4 hours, 5 hours, I'm falling downhill again.
Yeah. yeah.
You're a napper, though, right?
Oh,
you're
yeah.
Going to, you'll take a nap.
Oh, the best.
Maybe Pat and I will join you sometime for
what
that.
What a party.
Wait, are you marathoners going the whole distance?
Yeah.
I don't
nap.
But I sleep a decent amount at night, but I don't nap.
Oh,
not a nap. This one, he's a freak. He sleeps yeah. 4 hours a night and doesn't yeah. nap at all. He's also impervious to cold weather, which
yeah.
is also
that is true.
A lot of
there are many,
gifts.
Yeah.
And survives on eating raw onions. Yeah. You're like mm-hmm. some kind yeah. of
you
Soviet
were grown in a
robot.
Lab somewhere.
Still thriving.
All right, number two. We've probably all seen this photo. It's Albert Einstein sticking his tongue out. Turns out this photo was taken by Einstein at his 72nd birthday. He became annoyed with some photographer who asked him to smile for the photo, and this was his reaction.
Oh.
When he saw the photo, Einstein himself asked for a cropped version. And then he ordered a bunch of prints and he sent them out to his friends.
Funny.
All right, number one, we talked with former stuntwoman Georgia Durante on Friday. She was a stuntwoman, actress, model. She was married to the mob. She said this was the most exciting driving job that she had. She's the stunt driver for Roger Moore's daughter in the old car, Oldsmobile car ad from 1989.
Do what you want with the girl. I want the car.
We have an insight.
My father's Moore. Roger Moore. Dad's not the only one who'd love to get his hands on my new Oldsmobile Trofeo. It's precisely the kind of sophisticated technology he's always relied on. A visual information center. Lock brakes, FE3 suspension. It's everything he's dreamed a car could be.
Boy, I don't remember that one. That is still a crappy looking car. But that's the best Oldsmobile commercial I've ever seen.
That was exciting.
Yeah.
Oldsmobile was that agile.
Yeah. Well, that's a 9 and 9.
9 and 9.